My family runs a shipping business in San Francisco. We used to have two ships a week to Tokyo. We've been in shipping for two generations, Hank. I've never been on a voyage anywhere. I feel like Odysseus in the beginning of his journey.
The Odyssey took 10 years, Cole.
This is the American century. America can rule the world after we win this war.
We need to stay alive, Cole. These men are counting on us. But you're what the veterans are saying to each other?
No.
Golden Gate in 48. That's four more hard years of fighting.
Certainly wasn't that long, fortunately. The Fallen Idol. Holy hell, that's a big crash.
Bukowski, you have a new case. Two women, possible drink drive.
How is that a case?
The broad says she was doped and that somebody tried to kill her.
Where did this take place?
That's the bitch you're gonna love. Right across the street.
What?
Chevy Styline took a nosedive off the escarpment, fetched up underneath a Cola King billboard. Up to it, boys. We got bad guys to catch.
Amen to that.
I'm just praying the prince comes through so I can nail the son.
See you later, fellas. Try not to work too hard.
Look at you, bantering with the boys. Tear to my eye, watching that caterpillar grow.
I'm just trying to fit in.
Educated, hardworking, straight as an arrow. I break to you, Cole, but you'll never fit in.
We'll drive there so we have the car ready for when we eventually need to leave.
Jesus, Cole!
Alright, it wasn't that violent. Massive staircase. Imagine having to walk this every day. Lucky they didn't go over the whole edge. That billboard probably saved their lives. Familiar.
Well, that's June Ballard, Tarzan's sister, Beast of the Amazon. She's married to Guy McAfee. The captain has moved to Vegas now, but the two of them still have juice.
Phelps, traffic.
Detective Phelps. Hey, Bukowski. Long time no see.
You could have called this in by megaphone, Enrique.
Phelps, this is Enrique Gonzalez. Enrique was a pretty decent middleweight.
What do we have, Gonzalez?
Broad drives right through the empty lot and off the side of the escarpment. Her story is that a movie producer doped her and her friend and sent the car over the cliff.
Was anyone hurt?
Driver's beat up. Not too bad considering. If she hadn't hit that billboard, we'd be scraping both of them off the pavement.
That's what I said.
Jessica Hamilton. She's just a kid. She's pretty knocked around.
Kid gonna be all right?
I think so. They've taken her to central receiving. If you want to take a look around, just call the ambulance.
Thanks. Do that.
One more thing. Watch out for the driver. It cuts rough.
Alright, how do we get down
there?
The
corner, he's down by the crash site.
Down here.
You'll want to see this, Phelps. There, laid out on the trunk. And that isn't even the best part.
Why are these here?
They've been torn off. Where did you find them?
They were stuffed in the young lady's handbag. I'll run a trace for semen when I get back to the lab.
So that's a nice job to do.
She's a long way from home.
Indeed. Ow.
Looks like they're lucky they weren't more badly injured.
Must have been unconscious. Being relaxed tends to lessen the soft tissue damage.
Speedo is a bit optimistic at 140.
Drunk driver?
Maybe not.
How so?
Well, a head I found without a body piqued my interest. See what you think.
Alas, poor Yorick. I knew him, Horatio. Is it real?
No. I think it's supposed to be a replica of an Indian shrunken head. It's some kind of curio or movie prop. See the casting marks?
What's it made from?
Plaster of Paris would be my first guess, then painted.
So we can rule out the murder angle?
No, you can rule that in. That thing was wedging the accelerator to the floor. Whoever did it wanted these women dead.
It's not very nice now, is it?
You catch all the good. How does someone manage to tip their ride straight off a cliff? If the driver's in a fit state, we should ask.
Nothing else around here? Don't think so. Right, let's talk to her.
Mrs. McAfee, we would like to ask you a few questions, if that's okay.
I prefer to use my maiden name, June Ballard. You might be familiar with some of my work.
Can you tell us what happened here?
You're kind of cute for a cop. Maybe a bit on the serious side.
What about me, June? I'm a big fan of
you?
Beast of...
I don't like. Keep out of this.
We understand that you're still suffering from the effects of the accident, Mrs. McAfee. The officer says that you claimed that you were drugged. Who did this to you?
That rat slipped us a Mickey Finn. It's no wonder I feel so dopey. I can't remember.
It's a serious offense to withhold information from the police during a criminal investigation, madam.
I told you to call me June. You're making me feel like an old lady. And don't bother your handsome head about this. My husband will settle the score with Mark Bishop.
What can you tell us about the passenger in your car?
Jessica Hamilton. Poor Jessica. It's been a rough day for her. She's desperate to break into movies. What more can I say?
And she's your protege?
Damn it.
You could say that. Yeah, that's a nice way to put it.
We found a shrunken head. It was used to tamper with your car.
You see, I normally don't drive off cliffs. The last thing I remember is getting behind the wheel.
It's obviously some kind of movie prop. You must know where it came from.
In case you hadn't noticed, I am the talent. And the talent doesn't deal with props or sets or any of that kind of stuff. Why don't you ask Mark Bishop which prop house he uses?
You mentioned a Mark Bishop. You think he might have had something to do with this?
He is a movie producer. As for his involvement, you just leave it to me and my husband to worry about.
I want to know what happened between you two that made him want to commit a double murder.
Bishop offered me a part in his picture. Then he withdrew it. Fact is, we had a deal. I pressed him on it. And this is where I end up.
Mrs. McAfee, I think it would be in everyone's best interest if you accompanied Patrolman Gonzalez back to the receiving hospital.
I'm going to be okay. These guys can take me home after my lawyer and I have talked to the news house.
Mrs. McAfee, you are still under the influence of narcotics, and you're likely to go into shock once the drugs wear off.
And I thought you were a heel. It's nice of you to be concerned.
I think we're good here. Let's go see what we can shake out of the kid.
Once again, I get another one wrong. I'm nicking your car. Who else walking?
$11,000 Roger. And
take it easy.
Sorry.
Take it easy, Phelps. I'd rather get there in one piece.
Down the stairs we go.
Careful!
I am being careful. I'll get in this car.
Christ alive!
It's only a scratch.
Detective Phelps, here to interview a Jessica Hamilton.
Jessica Hamilton? Oh, yes. She's in the room, right behind me, Detective.
You can't hold me here. No, I don't need
feeling
to be
better since this morning, Jessica?
I need my lawyer.
A little.
Hey,
my head's
where is the telephone? Do you know who...
Hello, Jessica. My name is Cole Phelps. I'm a policeman. I'd like to talk to you about your accident, if that's okay.
Okay.
Can you tell me what you remember about the crash?
It's all kind of fuzzy. I remember waking up here. Nothing happened yesterday.
You're holding out on me, Jessica.
Please, I want my doctor. I'm not sure I can answer any more questions right now.
God's sake.
You need to get in touch with your parents, Jessica, to tell them what has happened.
Oh, you don't need to worry then. They sent me along to stay with Aunt June. They trust her to take care of me.
You're lying, Jessica. How are we going to make this right if you lie to us?
Please, Detective, why would I lie to you? Can't you just let me rest?
How did you meet Mr. Bishop?
Hey, getting these wrong.
Junie is a big movie star. You probably know that. She She's doing a new movie.
What do you know about Bishop?
He makes movies. I had to do a screen test. That's when you say some lines in front of the camera with the lights turned on you.
I know what happened to you, Jessica. Where exactly did it take place?
Please, it's scary. It's really difficult to think of anything.
Someone tried to kill you, Jessica. Do you get it? Forget about being in movies. It's time to act like a grown-up.
I had to wear a robe and lay down on a stone. There were lights, camera. It's not my fault. I'm not a bad girl. Why are you trying to hurt me?
You should think about going home, Jessica. You're getting mixed up with people who will treat you like last week's trash.
Are you crazy? I can't go home. I want to be a star.
That didn't go well at all.
It doesn't appear to be connected.
It's the tale of this town, Cole. Lambs that go willingly to slaughter. Who the hell is that?
Must be her lawyer. He certainly expedited her release.
I don't like it, Cole. Why is she in such a hurry? We should follow her. There she goes. Come on.
Oh, I hate tailing missions.
Officer needs help, 103 MD.
Ballard is definitely up to something.
I believe I got all those questions wrong. See, I might have played this game before, but still don't remember them all. God damn it. Try again. Not having much luck this episode, am I? Come on, load up.
It's the tale of this town, Cole. Lambs that go willingly to slaughter. Who the hell is that?
She could skip cutscenes, for God's sake.
Expedited her release.
I don't like it, Cole. Why is she in such a hurry? We should follow her. There she goes. Come on.
Ballard is definitely up to something. Seems to have made a remarkably speedy recovery.
It's green, go quicker. Oh, parking up.
Get in there and see what she's up to.
people out here, don't you? Then make some calls. I'm going to be very clear about this. You get this done, or I'm... Wilson's Hotel. Mr. Mark Bishop, that son of a bitch, lives in apartment 803.
She's gonna get him killed.
So what's the story? I'm guessing she didn't stop for light refreshments.
She made a call. Sounds like Mark Bishop has a heap of trouble headed his way. I've got an address. Wilson's Hotel, apartment 803.
Oh, shit. You better step on it.
If he's got any sense, he'll be as far away from home as possible.
If he had any sense, he wouldn't have tried bumping off Guy McAfee's wife in the first place. Or he'd done the job properly. McAfee will break a fella's legs just for looking at his brother.
What did you make of the kid? You believe her story?
I think she was doped out of her tiny mind and given the casting couch. That fucking bitch back.
Look out!
I think she was doped out of her tiny mind and given the casting couch. That fucking bitch Ballard sold her out.
So if Ballard was doing someone a favor, why did they try to kill her?
Come on, pick up the speed. So slow.
All units in the vicinity in car 11K, 11 King, a 415 in progress at apartment 803, Wilson's Apartment Hotel, 1220 West 7th Street, Westlake Park. 11K code 3, all other units code 2. KGPL clear.
I tried to stop them. It's room 803, left out of the elevator.
In we go.
Sounds like we're about to make it a hat trick of hysterical female witnesses.
Give it up, LAPD!
You and your children.
You shouldn't have taken this.
In the face. Keep losing my hat in these fights.
Are you injured, Mrs. Bishop?
I'm all right now. Those horrible, awful men.
Perhaps you should sit down, ma'am.
Yes. Forgive me, officers. I'm very flushed. I'll just sit down for a moment.
That's perfectly normal, ma'am. Take a moment while we look around.
Yes. Thank you. Look at this mess.
Give me my hat back. Irrelevant.
Presented to Mark.
Nope, indeed.
It would take a smarter man than me to connect that. Incidental.
What's this?
What do you have to do to earn $20,000?
God knows.
Silver screen.
Who are these men in the picture?
My husband, Mark, and Marlon Hopkins. They work together on occasion. That's Hopkins' shop.
Optimistic, Cole.
Just a little bit optimistic there.
Looks like the old movie set downtown.
I remember this mission a bit now that I've seen that.
Great Wall of Babylon. A replica of a replica.
I think we found everything now. Let's talk.
Those men, I think they work for Guy McAfee. You know the name?
No. Why should I?
June Ballard is married to Guy McAfee. Have you heard of her?
That slut. She's been badgering my husband for days.
Mrs. McAfee alleges that your husband tried to kill her and her friend last night. I think you should tell us what you know.
My husband's a movie producer. This has something to do with his movie picture. He doesn't include me in his business.
June Ballard said she had a deal to be in his new picture.
Mark repeatedly told her no. He had Joan Leslie lined up for the role. That's how he got the finance. June made all kinds of threats. She was very rude to me.
You know June Ballard?
We were both on the same picture a few years back. That's how I met my husband.
Where can we find your husband, ma'am?
He told me he would be on set. That's all I know.
You are complicit in all of this, Gloria. You know what happens to these poor, deluded kids, and you go along with it. I need to find your husband.
Why'd you come to Hollywood, detective? Handsome young man like you might find a little something in the movies. You've never thought about it?
No, I haven't.
Well, then you must be the only person in this burg who hasn't. We're born into temptation, detective. It's character that determines what we do about it.
Why is your husband paying Lorna Hopgood $20,000?
Lorna? Marlon's ex-wife? Are you sure?
You're lying, Mrs. Bishop. It's some kind of payoff. You know exactly what the money is for and who it's getting paid to.
Do I? Would you like to prove that, detective?
Your husband looks like he's being blackmailed. They obviously have something on him if he's prepared to kill to cover it up. Why is the payment going to Hopgood and not McAfee?
Lorna works at a check-cashing place in Hollywood. You need to ask Hopgood why he needs that much money in cash.
Your husband...
Well, he's got two out for you, right?
It could go easier for him if you were more helpful, Mrs. Bishop.
He's a big boy, detective, and so are you. This is Hollywood. There's always a deal to be done.
Operator, give me R&I.
Putting you through now.
Gonna move on.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need a location on a silver screen prop store.
Just a moment. Silver screen props, corner 3rd and Figueroa.
Thanks for your help.
All right, let's get down there. Back in the elevator.
An aging movie star, a wannabe starlet, and movie producer's wife. They're finally rubbing shoulders with the almost rich and famous. And from the stories they've given us, clearly none of them can act.
Seen if any of those newspapers with those backstory ones. Let's go to silver screen props.
Mrs. Bishop knows more than she's letting on.
She doesn't seem to realize how much trouble her husband is in. The LAPD are the least of their worries right now.
Yeah. You'd think she'd have gotten the hint after those hatchet men redecorated her apartment.
Maybe she's just loyal.
Or she's in on it. She didn't seem like your average giddy broad with nothing between the ears.
Or she might just be trying to buy enough time for Bishop to put a couple of oceans between him and the cat.
800 square foot palaces at home.
All units, officers, help. Major 415, 1624 West 3rd Street, 1624 West 3rd Street. Any unit to handle code 3, identify.
A smile on your face. So call us now. Bradshaw 2215. Elysian Fields, a quarter acre slice of victory.
Can't wait until we get a faster police car.
Phelps and Bukowski, LAPD. We are investigating the attempted murder of June Ballard and Jessica Hamilton.
Christ! I'm Marlon Hopgood. How can I help?
You hold castings here?
Let's hear about that. I got a little soundstage out back.
Lead the way.
Plenty of props.
Keep him here, Stefan. I'm gonna take a look around.
What's this got to do with me?
Don't try my patience, knucklehead. Turn off the lights, Hopgood.
Why would I want to do that? Humor him.
One-way mirrors. There's a room on the other side.
Huh. Well, well. Find a way into that peep den, Phelps. I'll stay here and keep our pervert company.
A lot of them around. Pills.
Doping a 15-year-old kid and abusing her in a screen test. What is wrong with these people?
And another one. That's about 9 million of them. prop sword.
Can't be that way, Phelps. You couldn't fit a rat through there.
Jungle Drums, 8th and Francisco. Attention, Mark Bishop.
Wonder what's on that. Reckon they're blackmailing him.
So what happened to the film of Hamilton's screen test?
Found all the clues yet. Oh, these bloody masks. Oh, shrunken heads even. Another backstory.
Listen, I have to call you back. I got some business here.
Sit down, Courtney. This is Mickey. Mickey, this is Courtney Sheldon. What would you like to drink?
Scotch. Straight up. I hear you're back at school learning to be a doctor, kid.
Yes. That's right, Mr. Cullen.
You want to be a doctor and a dope peddler. Interesting combination, huh?
Do we have a problem, Mr. Cullen?
We might have, yeah. Selling your dope to my boy Lenny looked like a good move, but Lenny has been supplying, wholesale, so to speak. The Bindle boys in this town aren't used to the juice without a little of the middleman taking his cut.
Lenny promised that wouldn't happen, Mr. Cullen. And Lenny works for you.
What can I say about Lenny? Anything. Oh, yeah, it's a putz. And he's lazy, and he's greedy, but he's my wife's brother. How can you make a cake with those ingredients, huh?
So how is that my problem, Mr. Cullen?
Well, kid, the only way we're going to be able to make this work is to do some repackaging. We need to get the dope out of those dinky little cardboard boxes and...
Surettes.
Yeah, surettes. Great. Put into a big vat so we can water it down a little.
I won't bore you with the chemistry, but it doesn't work that way. You're likely to kill even more people.
Okay, listen. We want to buy you out, kid. I'll offer you $50,000. Hey. Hey! You don't like my offer? Sheldon kid? I think I want him dead.
You think or you do? Because there's a big difference between one way or the other, that's for sure. Oh, it's taking its time loading, come on. Only have to zoom back out of the newspaper. Shouldn't take that long. Nothing in there. It's a hat. See, I'm good at this game. I know it's a hat. Don't know whether I've got anything or not, but oh well.
You ever do any work for Mark Bishop?
Mainly do work for the studios. RKO, Republic, Warner Brothers. So yeah, when Bishop is doing work for a studio, yeah.
When did you last see him?
Yeah, I'm doing work for his next picture. Still pre-production though. Haven't seen him around here in a while.
He was here yesterday, and something happened that pushed him over the edge. You're holding out on us, Hopgood.
You know, I have very good connections with the Vice Squad.
And well, there's a surprise.
They won't appreciate you coming in here and strong-arming me.
McAfee's men are looking for Bishop. We need to find him first. Any idea where he might have gone to ground?
If he really tried to kill McAfee's wife, my advice to him would be to leave town.
You're delivering props to Jungle Drums on 8th Street?
Bishop is using that old rundown wreck of a set. That place is dangerous. But it might be a good spot to hide.
That's all for now, Hopgood. We're taking you in.
Phelps! Roy Earl, advice. Hold on a moment. This is clearly a Vice case. You've been roughing up my informant?
Hopgood is a Vice informer?
Yes, he is, Phelps, and a very important one. Look at that mug. Have you been upsetting these two officers, Marlin?
So we just drop it?
You do if you know what's good for you. You need to catch the movie producer before an angry husband does, from what I'm hearing.
I'll be making a full report to the captain, detective.
You do that, kid. We're all very impressed with you. Let it slide, Cole. Let's get at it.
Detectives!
Johnny Goldberg. You work for Mickey C.
That's right, detectives.
You wouldn't happen to know the guys who roughed up Mrs. Bishop earlier today by any chance?
No, no, not us. We don't do that kind of thing. It's the husband we'd like to talk to.
This is a police matter. You don't want to be taken in for obstruction of justice, do you, boys?
You could try the obstruction rap, but it won't stick. We could beat them.
You've had your 10 cents worth, gentlemen.
Bishop knows how the world works. McAfee hits him up for a movie part, happens every day. The Bishop takes it a step too far and tries to rub out Mrs. McAfee. Naturally, Guy is gonna get upset.
What made you think Bishop would be here?
We figure he might be planning a little accident for Hopgood, too. Those two guys have got some unfinished business. You let us know if you find Bishop. Guy McAfee can be a very generous man.
I'm only gonna warn you once, gentlemen. Stay out of this. This is a police matter. We will be bringing Mark Bishop into custody.
At least he's polite. Kind of dumb, but polite.
But I'm a lot less polite, you smug son of a bitch. So let me put it in ruder terms that even a pair of blockheads like you might understand. The only reason that you don't have bars on your windows already is because you're small fry. And we don't waste our time on small fry. You stay away from Bishop, and you stay away from me. Is that clear enough for you, asshole? Now run along back to your boss so we can pat you on the head and tell you what good boys you are.
Owned.
I don't think they like your little pep talk,
Kowski.
Oh, shit. Get us out of here.
What do you riddle those with bullets? They're on our ass.
I need to be closer, Cole.
They really don't want anybody getting efficient before they do.
Whoa.
Keep it steady. I'll try and bust his tires.
Shoot.
We need to lose those fools, Phelps.
Let's see him chase us now. Onto the movie set, Phelps. Let's roll.
Oh, Christ. And they say working traffic is like watching paint dry.
You know how to piss people off, Bukowski.
Hey, if they're prepared to gun down cops in broad daylight, McAfee really means business.
Seems like we're the only ones who want Bishop alive.
Our car got a bit screwed up there.
I have a good mind just to let him go work on the son of a bitch. I'm about done putting my life on the line to protect some child molester.
That's our job, unfortunately. They don't get to dole out the...
There's the slippery bastard now.
No.
God damn it!
Get him, Phelps. I'll cover the exit.
Mark Bishop, stop! LAPD!
Stop, asshole.
We're trying to help you, Bishop.
This is all a big mistake.
Oh, he's a slippery bastard. Show us how I'm not allowed to make steep stairs in LA.
It's us or McAfee's boys. Your choice.
I didn't do anything.
Crap set is falling apart. Ow. Here you go.
Bishop, that's enough. Make this any harder on yourself, Bishop.
It's Joe Ballard. Blackmailing me.
Stop.
Mark Bishop, you're under arrest for the attempted murder of June Ballard and the rape and attempted murder of Jessica Hamilton.
All right, I'll come quietly. Just don't kill me. If you found me, then McAfee's Gooden will too. Oh, we need to get out of here.
Right, oh, they're already here.
Any tricks, and I'll save McAfee's boys the trouble.
Follow me. I know another way out of this place.
It's a lot of guys.
Christ, detective, they're trying to kill me.
Oh, shit.
Last chance to back the hell down. McAfee doesn't make the rules. You hear me?
Kill them, for God's sake! I don't want to die!
Wait.
There's no way out of here. I thought you said you knew where you were going.
We have to jump for it.
LAPD, you're making a big mistake. Find some cover.
All right, genius.
Come on, it's this way. Is this really the best McAfee's got?
You're dead.
Weapons on the ground now.
Boom, baby.
Get back to there. There's a ladder leading to the ground. For the love of God, how many are there?
All the way. Get some burn on the hands there.
Get him over here, I'll cover you. Come on, the cavalry's here.
Fall down.
Stay down.
Barrels
on the base of the
elephant. Whoa. Well, this movie set ain't gonna have any movies set on it anymore.
We need to get him to the car. There's an army of them. We're stuck.
Give me a machine gun.
Get into the car. I can cover you from here. You're almost there. This way.
Oh, they're cops. Oh shit, what are you running in front of me shooting a gun for? AI, I swear. Dumb as a box of bricks.
Get him over here, I'll cover you! Come on, the cavalry's here!
Ah, oh, dear. Why the hell would you run out in front of someone shooting a machine gun? I do not know.
McAfee doesn't make the rules.
Got everybody with this one shot.
Follow me. We need to get him to the car. LAPD, you're making a big mistake. Weapons on the ground. Now. The best McAfee's got?
Evidently so.
Find some cover! Oh my god, they're everywhere! Get into the car, I can cover you from here! You're almost there!
How long do you think you can hold out?
Get me out of here.
me some cover.
All right, let's kill these rat bastards.
Why don't cars blow up?
Now this is what I call a result. Mark Bishop, erstwhile film producer, an all-around piece of shit, catches a fast ticket to Quentin for statue rape and attempted murder. So he gets to spend the next 15 years playing sissy instead of sticking it to little girls. That is justice with a capital J. Developed such a reputation, I'm not going to be able to hold on to you any longer. You're getting promoted. Go on, get your new assignment. It was good working with you, son.
Yay, promotion. I guess it's with this guy.
Phelps, Bukowski.
This your work? Can I help you, detective?
Sorry, Cap. Didn't see you there.
Yeah, I'll bet you didn't. This is a traffic case. You need something?
I'm here to buy a drink for the two LAPD traffic cops who broke the back of Guy McAfee's private army. You don't have a problem with that, do you, Captain?
Go right ahead.
Get in. I'm buying. You'll like this place. A lot of movie people hang out here. You like jazz, Cole? The hopheads love it.
Sure, I guess.
Big bands and swing, I can understand, but this bebop palaver? How are you supposed to dance to that? This is Phelps, Leroy. Be nice to him. You'll like this place. They treat you right.
You like a table, Roy?
What do you think we want to do? Stand at the bar like
I'll
chumps?
I'll get a table ready for you.
Don't look so happy to see me, Alphonse. I might get the wrong impression. Cole, this is Alphonse. He's a French Negro from Africa. Can you beat that?
The Congo.
Pleasure to meet you, Alphonse.
Is Elsa singing tonight?
Yes, she is. She has the next set.
Come on, Cole. You can meet Elsa while they're fixing us a table. You'll like her. She's something else.
Maybe another night, Roy. She's pretty beat up about it.
Get your hands off me. Don't ever tell me what to do or what not to do, Alphonse. You got a nice club here. Don't spoil it.
If you will follow me, detectives. Just through the door.
He was my only real friend, Harlan. We went through it all. Do you realize what he meant to me?
Of course I do.
You have no idea. You said it was construction work.
It was an industrial accident, Elsa. How can I be held responsible?
Elsa, are you going on?
Louis, for God's sake, he was my best friend. The only man who ever loved me without putting his hands on me.
Hi, Elsa. Here's someone I'd like you to meet. Cole Phelps. War hero and crime fighter extraordinaire.
And why would I want to meet another fascist from the LAPD?
Sorry about this, Cole. What an evening I'm having. First a Negro puts his hands on me, and then this. Who do you think you're talking to, you German junkie whore? Don't you ever forget your place with me again. Do you hear me? Evening, Doc. How's business?
Sanguine. Louis, help me here. I'm gonna have to give her something before her performance.
Blow it off, Cole. These artsy-fartsy types always get a little flighty. Meet Dr. Harlan Fontaine, doctor to the stars. Mr. Fix-It to the mental wreckage of Hollywood. So what about that drink, boys?
And there we go, so we didn't get all that many questions right this time around, less than half, so pretty poor on that front, but we did get most of the clues. Barely any city damage, but a fair bit of vehicle damage, but then again we did a crash, well, it being a car chase, so I guess that's the, for, you know, gonna happen when you're in a car chase with guns and crashing, but yeah, we didn't do all that well with Jessica's questioning, and that's where we fell down the most, so yeah, gotta do better next time around. But we're promoted to the home side desk, so we'll definitely be doing that with the next case.